Hello everybody, in today's video I'm just going to be sharing my blush collection, specifically my cream blush collection, because I have become a big cream girl. And also I'm not going to be doing much makeup until this situation on my eye goes away. But let's just get into these blushes that I love. Okay, I have to put my glasses on because I'm blind as a bat. But let's start off with the first blush that started it all for me. I got it in a Petit Wore box, my first subscription box, I think, maybe possibly. But it's this Juice Beauty blush. It's like a bright pink color, very creamy, blends very easily. It's not too pigmented, but this is in the shade Seashell. And this is my oldest blush. Could be anywhere from 3 to 4 years old. I still love this color, but I have not touched it in like so long. I used to use it all the time. Another blush that I have is this Burt's Bees All Glow one. It's in Dahlia Dew. It's a very nice, like, reddy color, and I really loved it during the summer. I took it on a trip to Hawaii, and I literally wore this just every day with like a cream highlighter, and that was it. This I wouldn't wear over foundation. It's like very, very dewy, which, I mean, it says in the name, All Aglow, and the name is Dahlia Dew. It's very, very dewy. So I don't think this is foundation friendly, but if you love the dew, it's very pretty. And I just got it because I didn't have a color in my collection like this. A newer one to my collection is this Rare Beauty. I know it's not technically cream, it's a liquid, but I thought I would just, you know, keep it in here. I got it in the shade Joy, which I believe is the Dewy Formula. Yeah, Dewy Formula, and it's like, they describe it as a muted peach, but I think it's a tad bit bright for a muted peach, but it is peachy, which is right up my alley. And it's very, 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 very pigmented. I overdid it on the demo that you guys are seeing on the screen. I overdid it. I put too much blush on. But you know, it's better for you guys that I made that mistake, because you guys can actually see the color. It's beautiful. Favorite kind of colors are corals and peaches, which I think you'll see is a trend in my blushes. Another one that another cream blush I have is this Mini Milk Makeup blush in the shade Work, which is a dusty rose according to them. This was actually the first time I put this on my cheeks, and I really, really, really love the color, and I don't know why it took me so long to try this. I got it as one of those birthday perks from Sephora, and it's just been sitting in my makeup drawer not being touched, but I'm definitely gonna start using this more. I love this color. But it's safe to say, actually, I love every single color in my collection. There's a, like, not one that I hate. So, I'm happy about that. Because there are a few other ones that I've never used before, and I realized I need to use all of these more. Just have like a hodgepodge of cream blushes on my face. Another one that I have never really used is this one from Tani Beauty. Not sure what the name is, but I'll look it up and I'll like write it on the screen. But it's this beautiful, like, wine. Maybe not as deep as a wine. A wine pink color, fuchsia, wine fuchsia color. It's very, very creamy. So creamy. It's juicy. It's perfect for those juicy cheeks, like Rianne says, you know. I have to use this one more. I'm not really into these like pink wine colors usually, but I got this in my Petit Wore box, so which is why it's in my collection, because I think otherwise I might have not purchased it. But I need to try this more. It's really nice color. I should venture out of my comfort zone. I'm gonna go into my Ritual Defee blushes. I only have two of these cream ones. I wish I had more, because I actually love the formula. Love it. But I have the shade Delirium, which is more of like an orangey tone with like shimmer, gold shimmer in it, I think. I believe this has gold shimmer on it. Beautiful. I think this is one of my all-time favorite blushes to wear. And the name just reminds me of one of my favorite comic books, The Sandman by Neil Gaiman. Deliriums, and it's one of the character names, if you don't know the comic book. But enough about that. The other second shade I have is Nymph, which, okay, I purchased this one, and it was because it was out of my comfort zone, and I just really loved how it looked on the models. So I was like, it might be too much for my pale, pasty skin, but I actually really love this color too. It's beautiful. I love all my colors, like I already said, so I think if there was to be like a least favorite blush, it might be the Burt's Bees one, but, or this next one I'm going to talk about, those might be like the bottom tier, but I still love them. This other one's called Pretty Baby from Habit Cosmetics, and it's a nice nude peachy pink, more peach. It's what I have on my cheeks right now as I'm talking to you. This one's very light, it's buildable, so it's not like pow, wham, bam in your face right away. You can build it up, which is great, super creamy. And one of my newer ones too, I also got this in Petit Bourg box. Petit Bourg is one of my addictions, and it clearly fuels everything else because I'm now addicted to cream blush. Another one that is the opposite of that Habit one, it is extremely pigmented, as you will see in the demo, is my Mad Hippie cream blush in the shade Poppy. It's very poppy. It's a poppy color. It's very burnt orange poppy flower kind of shade. I love it. I've gotten compliments wearing this shade. It's very firm in the pan. You just need to warm it up with the warmth of your finger, but once you do that, you get a lot more than you need. So I like always tap off on my hand, like to make it a palette, and like then put it on my cheeks. But it's still way too much. I haven't used it in a long time, so like I kind of forgot. But this is pigmented, and I always wanted to try more shades from them. I love this shade. I should stop saying that because I love all of them. But that's my most pigment. That's more pigmented than the Rare Beauty one. And those are like the top two pigmented ones that I have. And I probably shouldn't have purchased them because of my skin tone, but I couldn't resist. I love the color. You know? The heart wants what the heart wants. Another one in my collection is this Kosas 8th Muse one. And I think it was like one of the first ones I purchased. I believe so. Which it's also, I went for this color because it's like out of my norm. Also, I didn't want to keep just repeatedly buying the same shades because I really want the Helios one, I think it's called. It's like, that's the orangey one. Really want it. Probably eventually we'll get it. But super creamy, dewy, beautiful, like pink color. I think it's more neutral to cool, but it's a beautiful color. Very buildable. It's perfect for spring. Like, I should use this in a video for an upcoming like spring tutorial. This would be like perfect for that. And I believe the last four are like my all-time top favorite, and it's my Salt New York blushes. I have four of them, and the shades I have are Rose, Coral, Spice, and Cranberry. Spice and Cranberry are the newest shades that came out for like the holidays, and it was my first time trying those on in this demo because I'm waiting for the palette to restock for Salt New York so I can. I have the small palette, but it's completely full, so I bought like four more shades. I just need the bigger palette. I just want to have the bigger palette and just like put all eight of my shades in that one palette and then use the smaller palette for like. I always want to try Cure Wise. So I might put Cure Wise in here, maybe some eyeshadows, we'll see. But I have those shades are beautiful, and especially Spice. Spice. I'm just gonna keep repeating it. Spice is the most beautiful blush I have ever put on my face. And it's perfect. It's the perfect spiciness I need in my life. And They're so creamy, they're buildable, I believe the two new ones I got were like the reformulated ones, because I believe they're all vegan now. And I didn't notice a difference in the formula from the first set I bought in these, unless I had bought them when they all were already reformed. By the way, beautiful. Favorite blush. If you haven't tried Salt in New York, I would recommend them to you. I'd recommend all of these blushes, just with like some caveats, like this Mad Hippie one. Be careful. Very pigmented. I've used it a lot and I barely made a dent in it. But yeah, that's my blush collection. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. The demo probably wasn't the best application of blush, so please ignore that. But I hope you guys will like and subscribe. And I can't wait to hang out with you guys in my next one. Bye.